Hello, people of the internet, and this is Grand Truck Simulator. So this game came out today. Actually, it's still in some beta. The game is still in beta, but it is out, and let's take a look at it. So this here is the main menu. Here on top you have your money, your points, your skill points that you use to buy better trucks. You get points by finishing deliveries. You have your kilometers, how much your truck has driven, your job, and here you have tech specs of your truck, engine size, horsepower, torque, gears, maximum speed, tank and traction. Down here you have three options: jobs, settings and exit. Let's take a look at settings. Here you can adjust various settings, of course, resolution, FPS limit, lights, all other stuff. I do recommend, if you download the game, I do recommend to turn off the traffic, because it is horrible. But as I said, the game is in beta. There are a few things to polish, but let's take it for a spin. So the first time you install the game, you will get this exact scene, but you'll have to buy a truck. You have, I think, $52,000 at the beginning, and this is the only truck you can buy at the beginning, at least now. So once you have bought your truck, hit the jobs, and you can select a job you want to drive. Also, you can buy other trucks, for example, this one. But as you can see, you need a Class C driver's license in order to work with this type of truck. Must complete some jobs to get higher license. I'm bloody sick. You can also hire drivers, for example, that one, or this one, or this one, or Victor, or Jefferson, J.O., Bruno, etc., etc. So let's find a job. So hit jobs, and right now I think I'm here. So let's see, is there anything beginning? Okay, so soy from Rufford to Mumbaka. Right. Also, in this game you can use mods, skins for trucks and trailers. That's still have a lot to be, done, but it is an option. So once you have selected your job, hit select. Oh, bloody focus. And drive. Of course, there are ads, but I can live with that. There are no ads in the middle of the gameplay, only these video ads when you hit drive. So that's a huge plus. And it is loading. And here we are in my Scavia. Not Scania, Scavia. Also, if you would like, you can read more about this game on my site. You will have the link in the description below. So here we are in the truck. I will mention though that the performance is a bit sluggish. Let's turn around. Also, one thing, the sounds are really awesome. Up here we have different options, lights, different settings for steering. You can use a controller, an Xbox 360 controller, if you can connect that to your phone, which is awesome. But let's use that for now. Okay, right now I'm here, and I have to get to here, bloody hell. Check out that sound. I have to say, the sound quality on this thing is bloody awesome, unlike some other UMP type driving games. So just get, first of all I need to get to the roundabout. Also of course there are traffic laws, and if you break some laws you will get a penalty. You can also do a burnout, as I will demonstrate. Just a sec. Well, some sort of a burnout. You hold the brakes, hold on. You hold the brakes and throttle. That's really cool, I have to say. Right now, let's put my foot down. I got in touch with the developer some time ago, and he gave me a long list of features that will be available for this game. And I did write an article about that on my site. It has more than 3,000 hits. Yeah. And pretty much everything he mentioned that will be in the game is in the game. Also, if you want to activate cruise control, double tap the throttle and it activates cruise control, which is really nice. Right now we are not on, as you can see there is a speed camera somewhere around here. There is. Slow down a little. And I got a ticket. Lost. Oh well. One thing to mention. Fuel is bloody expensive. Oh! Shoot. That was not supposed to happen. Alright. Where to next? Okay, so I have to, oh my god, this is gonna be a long ride. Alright, let's go then. This is one really, really big roundabout. You also have blinkers. Or turn signals, whatever you want to call them. Yeah, also the map right now as is, it's a bit, it's quite small. But that will change. Oh my back is killing me. That will change with time. So let's refuel. Sorry for the interruption. My mom called me in the middle of recording. Right, once we have topped off, let's go. Some other things I want to mention about this game. Different trucks have different fuel consumptions, and also that also varies how you drive the truck. And since I tend to drive a bit fast, my fuel economy is not, it's not something you would like to. Wait. So I have to take a right here. I can't tell that here. Never mind. The speed limit is 110 kph. I don't think this truck can go that fast, actually. But the sound is awesome. What would I like to add is manual transmission, like on the left side here. Manual transmission, that would be really awesome. Yeah, this truck is slow a lot. And as you can see, I have 12 minutes to finish this delivery. Okay, let's slow down. Where to enter that? Straight ahead. Oh, thank you. A good driver always uses the side blinkers, turn indicators, whatever. But a good driver does not drive like I do. Okay. There are different ways you can park. You can use the top camera or rear view mirrors, but since the game tends to lag and stutter with the rear view mirrors, I'm just going to do it like this. Damn it, Mickey. Damn it, Jim. Come on. Oh, good enough. Start the engine and you will wait for workers to finish. I think it should be loading the truck. Present continuous, not present simple. Yeah. You can see me there. You will get some documentation for your cargo and done. Right. Let's get driving. Turn on the engine. Also, the sound inside the cabin is a bit different. As you can hear. Right, let's go. Oh yeah, this is gonna be a long delivery, I think. When you start to spin tires a bit too much, you will get this. Are you stuck? Are you stuck? Cancel job and request towing service. We are not stuck, we are just doing a burnout. I think if you tap the brakes 2 or 3 times, you activate the handbrake. That's my theory. Alright, so straight ahead is good. Steady as she goes. I'm out of focus, really. Straight ahead. And the map does affect performance a lot. Yes, I know I'm weaving in and out of the lanes. Oh no. Oh, a blast. Another speeding ticket. I'm gonna turn on the lights. Okay, let's go. Since this is, I think, the weakest and slowest truck in the game, it's not really fast. You have, so far, 2 truck manufacturers, Mercedes and Scania. Its name's Scavia, and Mercedes, oh, bloody hell, brake, damn it, brake! Oh. Ouch. That hurt. Let me check something. No dents or anything. Good, good. Moving on. This game, as far as I heard and know, requires 1 GB of RAM and a dual core 1.2 GHz CPU on your phone. So yeah, this is not really a game for low-end devices. This Huawei has a quad-core CPU, 1.8 GHz and 2 GB of RAM. We are almost there. Almost. 95, 96 KPH. Oh, key image. Whatever. Now you come on, truck. Drive faster, man. Put some muscle into it. Was that 60? Or I think it was 60. I might want to slow down a little. After this, I will go to the server station just to see how it looks like. Yay. Okay. Also, the braking on the truck, is, according to the developer, as he told me, is kind of, let's say, adaptive. If there is an obstacle or an object in front of you, the brakes automatically apply maximum pressure. If you're driving and you hit the brakes, and it kind of slowly and gently slows down the truck. So, keep that in mind. Majestic parking job. Put it in neutral, shut down the engine, and please wait while the workers finish unloading the truck. Done. And right now you should get this. Work done. As you can see, $1,000 went down the drain for traffic tickets. And I got a total of 1,600 points. Okay, so let's head to the service station just to see how it looks like. And this time let's use the cabin view. Ah, bloody focus. Damn it. Come on. There we go. I mean, I have to keep one eye on the game and one eye on the camera on the other phone I'm recording with. Yeah, how I'm getting rid of this. You also have hazard lights here, but we don't need that yet. I can't turn left. See? I don't know if you can see that, but that is an arrow. You know what? Screw it. I don't care. This is the... Yep, this is the service station. Oh, that looks nice, I have to say. but it's gonna be tricky to park this thing. A truck on a ramp. Are you serious? Oh yeah, this is the okay job. Easy. There we go. To repair or mod your truck. That's nice. So what do we have? So you want to turn down the volume so you can adjust your suspension. Hello? You can adjust. Damn it. So, oh goodness. So you can adjust your height, spring, and damper for rear and front wheels. Damn it, these controls are a bit tricky. I don't know if you can see it. Pimp my truck. This ain't free though. Oh, no. Actually, hold on. Get low. I have no bloody idea what I'm doing. Nope, not gonna purchase. This is the lights, as far as I can tell. Here, Pantana turbina is a Brazil mod. It consists in welding a metal part inside exhaust manifold to obtain more beautiful sound at deceleration. You want to install it? Ooh, this sounds nice. Voila. Nope. I can install it. Here is brake. Brake assist. Brake assist activates an audible and visual alarm when it detects an obstacle in front of the vehicle. If driver does not respond to the alarm, the brakes are automatically applied to avoid collision. Nope. I think that's it. Your truck is not damaged, you don't say. And here. Grand Truck Simulator default. What? Never mind. So that's it. I have to say I'm really, really pleased with this game. And the game was delayed and delayed and delayed and delayed again, again, again. But you have to understand that the game is made by one single dude. So keep that in mind. And the graphics are good. Physics are beautiful, sound is awesome, gameplay is okay, I mean it's actually real good. You can hire drivers, you can mod, you can use mods. That's really awesome for me. That's a huge plus in my book. That's it. If you want to download the game, you can check the link in the description. And that's it. Thank you so much for watching, like and subscribe. And I will be seeing ya. Peace.